What's going on YouTube? This is DJ, aka Retrospective Dave, coming at you again with another video. And today I'm going to be discussing a topic that is very popular in sneaker culture and has been for quite some time. And that is counterfeit sneakers and whether or not StockX is selling fake sneakers to their customers. But before we get into the video, I'd like to thank all of my subscribers for being patient with me as I've been making minor upgrades to the channel. I've added new lights, a new backdrop, a new camera lens, a new location. So I didn't want to upload a video without taking care of all of that first. So please forgive me for not uploading in a while, but thank you so much for being patient with me. And to my new subscribers, if you're new to the channel, my name is Retrospective Dave. And on this channel, you can find very detailed and honest sneaker reviews, on-feet visuals, sneaker restoration tips and techniques, any and everything that has to do with sneakers. So if you love sneakers as much as I do, please do me and yourself a favor by subscribing to the channel. And let's jump into the video. So for those of you who do not know, StockX is a website that acts as a stock market for sneakers. So you have a seller and you have a buyer and you have StockX in the middle. So the seller will post an asking price, the buyer will place a bid, and once that asking price and that bid meet, then StockX in the middle will make the transaction. They will give the seller X amount of days to ship the shoe. The shoe will go to StockX. StockX has a team of people that verifies the sneaker to make sure that they're authentic. And then once they pass inspection, then they are sent to the buyer. So before I continue, I just want to say that StockX is not sponsoring this video whatsoever, nor are they paying me to say anything nice about them. So the views and opinions expressed in this video are coming from a real place. I'm going to be completely unbiased and I'm going to speak my piece. So what I have in front of me are two turbo green Air Jordan 1's. One is a size 10.5 from StockX and the other one is a size 12 that I got from a guy named Patrick Haith that runs a consignment store in Spartanburg called Upstate Footworks. So I feel like this video is needed because I was able to verify these shoes myself to see if they were authentic or not. And they are 100% authentic, and here's why. So I actually entered a raffle with Hibbett Sports and I hit for a size 13. When I got the 13, it fit a little bit big on me because I have 13s in my collection from back in the day and they fit pretty snug, but a lot of these newer sneakers that are being made now, they have a little bit more room in them, so the 13 doesn't fit me the same. So I called up Patrick and Patrick told me that he had a size 12, and at first we were going to size swap for him, but then a friend of mine called me and said that he didn't hit for the 13, so I decided to buy this pair from Patrick, keep the 13 and give it to my friend. He ended up changing his mind, so I took the shoes back to Hibbett Sports. But before I did that, I was able to compare the two because the size 13 came from a retailer. This came from Patrick, and I was able to compare the two right then and there, and everything checked out. These are authentic. All right, so this is the size 10.5 that I ordered from StockX, and this is actually for a friend of mine who actually wanted these, and he told me that since I had a StockX account, he just asked if I could order the shoes for him. So he gave me the money to order the 10.5, and here they are. So what we're gonna do is just compare the two and see if these from StockX are actually fake. All right, so before I compare the sneakers, I wanna compare the boxes. This is the size 10.5 from StockX, and I just wanna show you what you will receive in the box when you order from StockX. So you will see this white card here. Snap a pic. Show us your verified authentic tag, blah, 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 blah. On the flip side, welcome to the future. CEO is Josh. You will also get this invoice or receipt. That's my name up at the top. Order number, Jordan 1 Retro High Turbo Green. Condition, new, 100% authentic. Price, $207. And you will also receive the sticker from StockX. So that's what you will get in the box. That's not to say that everything is authentic. That's just what comes in the box when you order from StockX. All right, so the first thing that I look for when I'm comparing the boxes are the labels that are placed on the box. So let's look at the size 12 first. I have a size 12. Let's see if I can get it in focus. Made in Vietnam. Air Jordan 1 Retro High OG Turbo Green Sail White. Barcode 87229-65597. And this little barcode has a 16 in there. They suggest the retail price is $160. And it also has a sticker up here, 41000307 04, the letter K on the bottom right. I don't know what this number means, or I don't know what either one of those numbers mean, but let's look at the size 10.5. 10.5 label looks the same. Made in Vietnam, Air Jordan 1 Retro High OG. 87229-65594. The little barcode says 16, and that's pretty much the same as this one. That little number right here underneath the Air Jordan 1 Retro, it says 55508831. On the size 12, 55508831. Same number. Suggested retail price is 160. Only thing different is this label up here from this one. Numbers are different. The bottom number is the same, and it still has that letter K at the bottom right corner, but that number at the top, this one has hyphens, the StockX one doesn't. So on the bottom, they both have that Nike branding, and the stickers in the same spot. The size 12 has that swoosh, small font. And the StockX 10.5 has that same swoosh, same font. Let's take the lids off. Got your Nike stamp right there. Size 12, swoosh written at the bottom. Stock Xbox, stamp, swoosh on the other side. You see the dimensions written in the corner of the box. So this is a size 12, you can see the dimensions. 13 AJ and 18, 330 by 235 by 120. This is the size 12 box. 10.5 stock X box. Has that same dimension. Okay, so that checks out. Also inside of the StockX box, has those same dimensions written. Camera can focus on that. StockX 10.5, size 12. Same dimensions. Also in the bottom of the boxes, you will see made in China, made in China. So far everything with the boxes check out. All right, let's take a look at the kicks. So the size 10.5. The first thing that I look for when I'm comparing Jordan 1's or Jordans in general is the shoe smell. And they both have a distinctive shoe smell, and they are the same. I don't know if that's the glue or the factory that it came from, but for all you sneakerheads out there that collect Jordans, you know what smell I'm talking about. It's that new shoe smell is very distinctive. And they both have that smell. All right, here's the StockX pair, 10.5. Off rip, you have the two lace bags with the turbo green laces and the purple laces. Should have that space in the bags. Rolled laces hanging from the top lace hole on the left shoe. Also, here's your verified StockX tag. On the size 12, same thing. two bags. Got the space up here. Hanging from the top lace hole, left shoe. That's the same. All right, moving on to the side panels. The 10.5 has that manufactured wrinkled look that I hate so much. And so does the size 12. You've got that SP19 Air Jordan 1 High OG. Size 12. SP19 Air Jordan 1 High OG. One thing that I noticed with the writing on the sides, the StockX one seems to be a little bigger. And the size 12 is a tad bit thinner. So I don't know if that's it's a difference, but I don't know if that's just a factory flaw or... Because not every shoe is just going to come out looking the same exact way. Here we are with the stitching on the size 12. Kind of sits above the Nike check. Same with the 10.5. Sits above the Nike check at that slant. The suede feels the same on both shoes. Let's look at the toe boxes. This is the 10.5. 10.5, size 12. They both have that wrinkly leather on the toe box. Obviously different patterns, but the same feel, same everything. Turbo green stitching on the size 12 all the way around. Same with this shoe. Alright, the tongues are the same. The size 12 has a higher tongue than the 10.5. I'm assuming that's because it's a bigger size. Both tongue tags feel the same. This is the size 12 tag. Let's see if I can get a size 12 tag. Ten and a half tag. Same feel. They both have that foam at the top. But yeah, this tongue on the 12 is noticeably taller than the tongue on the 10.5. So that's a difference. Size 12 right here, that same manufactured wrinkled leather. Same on this one, the exact same. Compare the backs. This is the size 12. It's taller than the 10.5. If you can see right there, this is taller than the 10.5. Again, that may just be due to the size difference. They both feel the same quality wise. Nothing noticeably different. Size 12, Air Jordan wings. It's got that raised lettering and design. 10.5 StockX, same raised lettering and design. Look at the inside. Turbo green mesh lining on StockX. Turbo green mesh lining on the size 12. And let's look at the inside. the insoles. This is the size 12. Nike branding. See that size 12 sticker on the inside of there. StockX. 10.5 sticker on the inside. So pretty much the same on the inside as well. All right, let's take a look at the inserts. This is the size 12 right here. The insert has this, I guess, Chinese writing. And the insert, Jordan Man. QF8H 10.5 to 12. So I guess this shoe tree fits a size 10.5 to 12. But this came out of the size 12. And this shoe tree, same Chinese writing. Jumpman. QF8H 10.5 to 12. Same shoe tree. Same exact shoe tree. Alright, let's look at the bottoms. This is size 12 right here. StockX here. 10.5. Bottoms are the same. And that's pretty much it for these. Starting with the sticker with a tag. This is a StockX 10.5. Let's look at this tag right here. Alright, that's a 10.5. Production date was September 19th, 2018. End of production was December 15th, 2018. And that number is 555-088-311. Made in Vietnam. And that 555 number is the same number as seen on the box. Same number. Alright, now let's take a look at the size 12 and compare it. Alright, size 12, 555-088-311. Same number, made in Vietnam. Production date is September 19th, 2018. End of production is 11/8/18. So the production date on the size 12 was before the size 10.5 on the StockX pair. But the 555 number is the same.
So the takeaway lesson is basically, if you don't have a shoe from the retailer to compare it to a shoe that you bought from an outside source, then you do run the risk of getting a fake sneaker. I'm not gonna say that StockX sells fake shoes or hasn't sold fake shoes, but I will say that when you're using a team to verify a shoe and you don't have the shoe from the retail store to compare it to the sneaker that people are sending to your company, sometimes you do run the risk of passing through a fake sneaker. So that's really the best way to verify the authenticity of a sneaker, because you can't just look at a shoe and just say, oh, it looks real, you know, so it must be real. I started collecting sneakers back in 2003, and back then, a lot of the sneakers that we saw that were fake, they looked fake. But nowadays in 2019, you have high quality fake sneakers, and I'm pretty sure there are still big differences between the fake one and the real one. But like I said, you just have to have the sneaker from the retail store to compare it to. All right, so that wraps it up for this segment. If you thought this video was helpful, please give me a like. Also, hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. And also, hit that notification bell to be notified when I upload new content. You can also follow me on Instagram, at RetrospectiveDave. And before I get out of here, I just want to say that if you're going to buy from an outside source, please be very careful and protect yourself. Do your research, do your homework, do whatever you got to do, because it's not 2003 anymore. You can't just see a shoe from a mile away and said that it's fake. It's 2019, so a lot of fakes out here are high quality, and you don't want to be caught walking around with some poopity scoops or some unscoopable kicks.
Bruh, I mean, y'all know what that nigga do over there, you know what I mean? I mean, pine greens, Gatorade greens, it seems like any green shoe you get from that nigga, you know what I'm saying?